don't know, I'm a senior this year. This is my last time up here. And what I've learned throughout my senior year is that change is a huge thing and it's a scary thing. And I guess I never would have expected it coming. I've never really had huge changes in my life. I've moved a couple of times. And that's the first thing that can come to my mind, at least. The biggest thing about change is just knowing how to deal with it, and that's a big part of what I'm learning right now. Some days I just want to cry because I'm not going to see my friends anymore, or not nearly as much. And some other days I'm happy because I know that they're going to be living their dreams, doing what they love to do, and as a friend, that's all I want for them. We go through life, and everyone has different changes, whether it's graduation, whether it's someone passing away, whether it's anything you go through. And I guess the biggest thing I want to tell you guys, and even though it's coming from an 18-year-old, and you guys are all much smarter than me, the one thing I want to say is if there's anyone in your heart, even if it's just that much, just give them a hug. Embrace who they are and what they are, and everything about them, no matter what. Because we're not here forever. And we need to take the moments to embrace the people we love. Because if we don't, then they're going to be gone too quick.
Thank you. Otherwise, would you might have not needed your protection. But I lied to you. This thing is time. A man was not created before. God, please retire me now.
Thank you. tough pill to swallow. We all learn to forgive at some point. If someone does you wrong, forgive them. Don't lose sight on what is important. He didn't.
Corinthians 5:17. There
I am beautiful, I am independent, I have a voice, I am strong, and if God is the only one who thinks so, that is all I need.
In the mirror, face to face with somebody less than perfect. I wouldn't choose me first. I was looking for a champion. In fact, I'd understand if you picked everyone before me. That's just not my story. True to who you are, you saw my heart. Stay quiet, I'm meant to be a lion. Oh, roar beyond a song with every moment that I've got.
You are, you saw my heart and made something out of nothing. I don't need my name in lights, my hands in my father's eyes. Make no mistake, he knows my.
Matthew 16, 24 through 26. And then Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever wants to be one of my disciples must deny themselves, then take up their cross and follow me. For whoever wants to save their life will lose it, and whoever loses their life for me will find it. For what good is it to gain the whole world, yet forfeit your soul? For what can you give in exchange for your soul?"
fortune lies beyond the stars, those dazzling heights too vast to climb. I jump so high to fall so far, but I found heaven as love swept low. My heart beating, my soul breathing, I found my life when I laid it down. Upward falling, spirit soaring, I touch the sky when my knees hit the ground.
Sometimes it feels like we don't take enough time out of our day to focus on God. We focus too much on worldly things instead of taking the time to practice the works and of our God and pray to Him. Psalm 16:8 says, I keep my eyes always on the Lord. With Him at my right hand, I will not be shaken.
Fix my eyes on you. hit rewind, click delete. Stand face to face with a younger me. All of the mistakes, all of the heartbreak, here's what I do differently. And talk the talk.
Everybody knows it, everybody knows
but
it.
But the road that's traveled is hard to walk.
Everybody knows it, everybody knows
it. It takes a soldier who knows his orders to walk the walk I'm supposed to walk.
God is greater than any negativity in our life. He's greater than our fears and our doubts. He's greater than the war and terror in this world. He's greater than any abuse we could ever endure or anything social media or people tell us that we have to be. Isaiah 40, verse 28 through 31 reminds us of this by saying, "Do you not know? Have you not heard? Our Lord is the everlasting God, creator of the ends of the earth, and his understanding no one can fathom. Even youth stumble and fall, and young men grow weary. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint." So you have to always remember, God is greater.
your tired and bring your shame. Bring your guilt and bring your pain. Don't you know it's not your name? You will always mean much more to me. Every day I wrestle with these voices that keep telling me I'm not right.
Not right.
That's all right, 'cause I hear a voice and he calls me redeemed. When others say I'll never be enough, and greater is the one living inside of me than he who is living in the world. Greater is the one living inside of me than he who is living in the world.
Bring your doubts and bring your fears. Bring your hurt and bring your tears. Don't use no condemnation here. Oh, you're holy, righteous, and redeemed.
Every time I fall, there'll be those who will call me a mistake. That's okay, 'cause I hear a voice and he calls me redeemed. When others say I'll never be enough, and greater is the one living inside of me than he who is living in the world.
In the world, in the world.
Greater is the one living inside of me than he who is living in the world.
Whoa, 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 he's greater, he's greater. Whoa, 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 he's greater, he's greater.
There'll be days I lose a battle. Grace says that it doesn't matter, 'cause the cross already won the war. I'm learning to run freely, understand just how he sees me, and he makes me love him more and more.
Every day I lose a battle, grace says it doesn't matter, 'cause the cross already won the war. I'm learning to run freely, understand just how he sees me, and he makes me love him more and more. 'Cause I hear a voice and he calls me redeemed. When others say I'll never be enough, greater is the one living inside of me than he who is living in the world.
In the world, in the world.
Understand just how he sees me, and he makes me love him more and more.
He's greater, he's greater.
Greater is the one living inside of me than he who is living in the world.
It was Liv. I love you, Livy. Wow, that was awesome, wasn't it? The hair is standing up on my arm, so it must have been really good. So our message today was about being made new. And we know that there are people in this room and just outside, and these kids, they're going through stuff and junk. And sometimes it just kind of weighs heavy on them. And if we as a church family can help them be made new, but they can also just peel those layers away and just see the face of God, and that we know that he's the greater one, we've done our job. And I'm so excited for these kids. They've done an awesome job. They work so hard on this. I'm so proud of you. I kind of just lost my train of thought, so I apologize for that. I'm overwhelmed. Thank you for coming this morning. I'm going to take a quick minute and introduce our class of 2018. These are kids that I have mainly seen grow up in this church. One of them from birth. But otherwise, yeah, it was Kyle. You're welcome, Tanya. So we have six graduating seniors this year, and I'm going to start over here in the soprano section, Miss Cassie Larson. In the alto section, Audrey Callahan and Kelsey Frame. And our three boys in the back, Kyle Olson, Noah Belting, and Everett Schmidt. It's always, 6 years ago was my very first musical with this group. Some of them were sixth or seventh graders, and I got to watch them grow up into beautiful young men and women, and now I get to see the sixth graders that come in and do a full song of a rap. Wasn't that awesome? Way to go, Hunter. What I love is the sixth graders coming in, because we have such an amazing music program at this church that when they leave Light of Life from Cindy Mama, and where's Marie? And Marie, they are ready to come up here and do a solo, and they do not have any qualms about it. They are excited to do a solo, and they're ready, and I loved it. Today, I think we had three sixth graders that did solos, so I'm very proud of them. They corrected me. Five. So that's even better. We're going to do Friends in the Faith. You know, most of you know this song. This is our song that we end all our musicals with, other than This Little Light. We'll get to that, I promise. But just remember that we are all friends in the faith, and Cindy has said it many times, and it just has burned in my brain. We got to stand in the gap for one another, and these kids do, and I'm proud of them. So I so appreciate everybody. Hi.
Hi.
I have all tall friends, by the way.
Right. So those of you that were here last night know that we did a whole slew of gifts and thank yous and all this stuff. So Sunny got a lot of departing gifts last night. For those of you that don't know, this is her last year. She is stepping down. And so she is handing over the reins to Anita and I for next year, and we just want to give a heartfelt thanks for, excuse me, it's actually 7 years of directing Solid Rock. Please give her an extra round of applause for everything that she's given to this program. And one extra little gift that we did not give her last night is her alumni shirt. We give these to all of our seniors, and our seniors got them last night, but our departing directors also get the illustrious alumni shirt. Thank you, Sunny.
Thank you. Thank you.
One other thing that we would like to do, we cannot manage this program without the incredible amount of help that our parents and other volunteers, we have volunteers in this congregation that they don't have kids or grandkids up here, but this program is in their heart for one reason or another, and they step up and they do an incredible amount of work behind the scenes. If there's one thing that I learned, I mean, I learned a lot this year, but if there is one thing that rises above the rest is how unbelievable you guys are as a congregation and how much work it takes to run this program and how you guys just step up at the drop of a hat and do what you need to do. If you have at all in any way, shape, or form this year or other years been involved in the Solid Rock program, could you please stand up right now? Look at that. Can we say an extra, extra special thank you to all of these amazing people for all the help that they have put into this program. Thank you so very much. All right, friends in the faith, guys.
Friends beyond the bounds of time.
Sing it, girls!
Nothing with God on our side.
Okay!
Standing together in the faith, we are bold to declare that Jesus
Jesus, Lord, we
You get it eventually. So I hope today that you were made new, that there was a moment in this service that just touched your heart, other than 40 youth singing to God. I think that's awesome. So as we leave this church, take your lights out, let them shine, don't hide them, because it's better when you let it shine. So we are going to end with one of our favorite songs, This Little Light, and all the kids, you are welcome to come up, and adults too, alumni. All right, let's do it, Jeff.
My gonna let it shine.
Oh yeah, baby. That's it. There we go.